Hi, I'm Keith Luscinski with the Petzl Technical Institute. In this video, we'll do a deep dive into Petzl's new Twin Release. The Twin Release is a releasable double shiv pulley with progress capture and an integrated swivel and openable side plates. The Twin Release is certified as an EN567 ascender on ropes 8 to 13 millimeters in diameter. It's also certified as an NFPA T-rated rope grab on ropes 10 to 13 millimeters in diameter. With a minimum breaking strength of 36 kilonewtons, the Twin Release is also certified as an NFPA G-rated pulley. Finally, when combined with the Axis 11 millimeter rope and spin L2 pulley, the Twin Release system is certified as an ANSI Z359.4 rescue system with a load of up to 280 kilograms or about 620 pounds. Let's look at each component of the Twin Release in more detail. The integrated swivel is the same as you'll find on our spin line of pulleys. The large attachment hole can accommodate up to two carabiners at a time, and with its smooth cross section, allows for direct connection of ropes and webbing. The two shivs each have moving side plates that open with a triple action mechanism. One of the shivs has a standard smooth cross section, while the other is the faceted shiv mounted on a one-way ratchet that you'll find on the spin L1D pulley. We'll see the purpose of this shiv in just a minute, but for now, note that this arrow indicates the direction of rotation for that shiv. Both shivs are mounted on sealed ball bearings with a 92% efficiency. This stainless steel cam provides for progress capture while hauling. This button allows you to activate and deactivate the cam. The cam is also actuated by this handle, which allows you to block and unblock the system. As we'll see during operation, the cam isn't intended to provide descent control. Instead, there are three features of the Twin Release system that allow you to do a controlled descent. First, with the Twin Release rigged into a 4-to-1 pulley system, the load on the free end of the rope is naturally reduced by a factor of 4. Second, while lowering, the rope travels over the faceted shiv in its stationary position. Finally, while lowering, we wrap the free end of the rope over the external brake. All right, let's see the Twin Release in action. We'll start by setting up the 4-to-1 pulley system using the Twin Release, Axis 11 millimeter rope, and the spin L2 double shiv pulley. Start with all four pulley side plates open and the Twin Release cam deactivated. Begin by tying a compact knot on the end of the rope to the becket of the Twin Release. I like to reeve the pulley shivs looking at the back side of the pulleys and reeving the rope in a clockwise motion. We'll start by reeving the rope through the L2. And as you reeve each pulley shiv, close the corresponding side plate. To ensure the system's been set up properly, check all four side plates, ensure they're closed and locked, and that the red indicator is not visible. We'll activate the cam, ensuring that the free end of the rope exits the Twin Release at this hand symbol. This is a good time to point out that the Twin Release was designed to be used in a 4-to-1 system. It can never be used on a single strand of rope for hauling or lowering. With the Twin Release system fully assembled, now we can put it to use in our operation. To demonstrate the proper use of the Twin Release, here we have a confined space scenario set up that requires a vertical haul and lower. To extend the length of the system, you can deactivate the cam. Once the system's extended, immediately reactivate the cam. With a live load on the system, never deactivate the cam. Main line ready. Belay ready.
All right, ready to lower.
To lower, always start with the rope over the external brake. Use one hand to provide tension to the free end of the rope, while your other hand operates the handle. Remember that on the twin release, the handle and cam don't provide descent control as with the rig, ID, and maestro. So open the handle fully. Now use your left hand to maintain the handle position and provide additional control to the rope. To stop, simply release the handle and the cam returns to the blocked position. If there's too much friction during the descent, you can remove the rope from the external brake. For high overhead anchors, you can control the twin release remotely using a small diameter cord. Make sure the cord is light enough that it doesn't impede the handle return mechanism. It's important that the hand controlling the cord is also on the free end of the rope. Having one hand control the cord and on the rope ensures that in the event your hands move towards the twin release, tension on the cord is released and the cam returns to its blocked position. Once we're ready to haul, no changeover is required. You can simply pull on the free end of the rope. While hauling, there's no need to operate the handle. The cam stays in the blocked position all the time. For maximum efficiency, be sure to pull in line with the system. That way you don't generate extra friction with the rope running over the cam. These were just a few tips on using the Petzl TWIN RELEASE. As always, for complete information, please visit Petzl.com.